After James Watson and Francis Crick had discovered the double helix structure of DNA, two scientists, Meiselson and Stahl, were eager to discover which of the three hypotheses about DNA replication were true. The first hypothesis was conservative replication. Here, it was assumed that the DNA completely duplicated itself. The second hypothesis was dispersive replication, where the DNA was believed to segment itself off into certain amounts of nucleotide bases and then make copies of those specific parts. The third hypothesis was semi-conservative replication. In this method, it was predicted that the DNA would unwind and the new strands would be copied based on the parent strands. In order to test which of these three hypotheses were true for DNA, Meiselson and Stahl completed an experiment involving E. coli, a nitrogen-14 medium, a nitrogen-15 medium, and a centrifuge. The reason they used a centrifuge is because the high-speed rotation of it would cause the DNA containing the heavier N15 to sink to the bottom of the test tube and the lighter N14 to float to the top. First, they took an Agar E. coli and an N15 medium and took a sample of their DNA. Then, they placed the DNA into a test tube to spin into a centrifuge. As predicted, the results showed all the DNA settling at the bottom of the test tube, 100% of it containing the N15 component. After this, they set the DNA into an N14 medium. The N14 medium is another medium where they also grew E. coli, but with a lighter, more normal nitrogen. They waited for the DNA to replicate and then placed the solution in a test tube into a centrifuge again. Once the test tube was removed, it was observed that 100% floated in the middle, containing the N14 and N15 nitrogen. This disproved the conservative hypothesis, because if it were true, there would have been a clear separation in the N14 and N15 DNA. Meiselson and Stahl once again placed the solution in an N14 medium, waited for the DNA to replicate, and placed the test tube in a centrifuge. They then observed that 50% of the DNA was in the middle, containing the N14-N15 mixture of DNA, and 50% was at the top, containing just the light N14 DNA. This result eliminated the dispersive hypothesis, which would have shown 100% of the DNA as a mixture of N14 and 15 components floating in the middle of the test tube. In order to confirm results, they repeated this experiment. When the test tube was removed, they found a shocking discovery. Almost 75% of the DNA was at the top of the test tube containing only N14, and 25% was in the middle of the test tube containing the mixture of the N14 and 15 DNA. This meant that the DNA strands containing the N15 unwound and when placed in the N14 medium made a copy of DNA that included the N14 component. Then the next generation of DNA unwound again, replicated, and resulted in a mixed copy and just an N14 copy, proving DNA replication was semi-conservative.